If you're planning to live in orbit, well, the International Space Station is not the only destination anymore because China is now the only country to have an exclusive space station called the Tiangong, which means heavenly place in Mandarin. But why did China build such a thing? Why did China refrain from using the International Space Station? Well, we have the answers for all that, so make sure to stick till the end to know a lot more about how China won the space race against America. November 29, 2022 was a big day for China because the Shenzhou 15 mission was launched from China's Gobi Desert carrying three taikonauts, which for those of you who don't know is the Chinese word for astronauts. 6 hours later, they reached China's recently completed Tiangong space station. The three taikonauts replaced the existing crew that helped wrap up construction. This was a successful mission, making China the third nation to operate a permanent space station. So what does this mean for China and the rest of the world? Well, this is an achievement that solidifies the country's position, alongside the US and Russia, as the world's top three superpowers. Unlike the ISS, which is a collaborative US-led international space station, Tiangong is entirely run and built by China themselves. The successful opening of the station is the beginning of something exciting in the new age of space race. The station also highlights the country's policies of self-reliance and will help the country to achieve larger space ambitions in a changing landscape of power dynamics in space. The Tiangong Station space station did not happen overnight. It is a culmination of 3 decades of work on the Chinese manned space program. The space station is about 180 feet or 55 meters long, and it consists of 3 modules that would launch separately and connected in space. These include 1 core module where a maximum of 6 taikonauts can live and 2 experiment modules with a total area of 3,884 cubic feet, or about 110 cubic meters of space, about 1/5 the size of the International Space Station. The station is also equipped with a robotic arm which can support activities and experiments outside the station, along with 3 docking ports for resupply vehicles and manned spacecraft. Just like China's aircraft carriers and other spacecraft, the Tiangong is also based on the Soviet-era design because it is pretty much the copy of the Soviet-made space station from the 1980s. But again, the Tiangong station, being the newer one, has been heavily modernized and improved. The Chinese space station is here to stay for at least 15 years with 2 6-month crewed missions and 2 cargo missions to it annually. The scientific experiments have already begun, with plans to conduct studies involving monkey reproduction commencing in the station's biological test cabinets. Even though we are not sure whether the monkeys will cooperate, especially in space. But what we know is that China is stepping up their game by showing us what they are capable of, and they are doing it because of one main reason. The International Space Station program's members include the United States, Russia, Canada, Japan, and 10 member states of the European Space Agency, including France, Belgium, Italy, Denmark, Germany, the Netherlands, Norway, Spain, Sweden, Switzerland, and the UK. But one global space superpower is totally absent, that is China. The US banned China from the International Space Station, because of which we have 0 presence of China in the International Space Station. The Tiangong Space Station is strictly Chinese made and managed, but China has an open invitation for other nations to collaborate if they really want to do experiments. So far, 9 projects from 17 countries have been selected. In December 2023, China is planning to launch a new space telescope called the Zhongshan. This telescope will be mapping stars and supermassive black holes, among several other projects, with a resolution that is comparable to the Hubble Space Telescope but with a wider view. This telescope will periodically dock with the station for all the maintenance activities. China is also planning to launch multiple missions to the Moon, asteroids, and Mars, with the goal of bringing samples back to Earth. The country is also planning to build a joint moon base with Russia, even though we don't have any timeline for this mission yet. The Tiangong Space Station is important because the International Space Station is almost at the end of its life cycle. After more than 30 years in orbit, it will be decommissioned by 2023. The International Space Station has always been a classic example of collaborative ideals in space, even with the Cold War between the US and the Soviet Union. But they came together to develop and launch space station in the early 1990s. The 90s was when China was still launching US satellites into orbit. But there were several concerns about China acquiring or stealing US technology. And that concern led to the Wolf Amendment that was passed by the Congress in 2011, which prohibited NASA from collaborating with China. The US also considered China's space program too immature to be a part of the construction of the International Space Station in the 1990s and the early 2000s. But by that time, China had the ability to contribute to the International Space Station. But it was a Wolf Amendment that prevented them from doing so. A 2015 report by the American government's U.S.-China Economic and Security Review Commission finally gave us the reason for this move by the country. The report stated, China's efforts to use its space program to transform itself into a military, economic, and technological power may come at the expense of U.S. leadership and has serious implications for U.S. interests. The new station is much smaller compared to the 16 bodies of the International Space Station. But the space station will support China's future space missions there by marking a new era of space race, which takes the excitement to a whole new level, especially because the International Space Station will be decommissioned by 2030.